all of us who work in this field really want to eliminate breast cancer as a public health problem. Unless we put that goal up on the wall and work towards it every day, we're not going to achieve it. It used to be that a woman who had positive lymph nodes for breast cancer pretty much routinely got a recommendation for chemotherapy. And it appears that if you look at the gene signature of the tumor that you remove, and there's been a gene signature of 21 genes that we look at, and you can classify the tumors into favorable and unfavorable biology based on the DNA analysis of these 21 genes. And it turns out that some patients who have positive lymph nodes really have favorable biology, and it's been pretty much proven that chemotherapy does them no good. There's a number of women who have small tumors with negative nodes who die of breast cancer, and this has befuddled us for a long time. And it turns out that if you look at the 21 gene signature of some of those tumors, they're really unfavorable. And so we're starting to be more aggressive with smaller tumors that never would have gotten systemic treatment before. We're really translational biologists. We have one foot in the basic science camp and one foot in the clinic. And what we're trying to do is interpret what's coming out of the laboratory and insert it into the clinic in a meaningful way. Well, in breast cancer surgery specifically, there are several areas that are really quite interesting. One is the use of radiation therapy in the operating room to do radiation treatment and surgery at the same time. This would potentially avoid women having to spend 5.5 weeks getting radiation therapy after their surgery.